Hello, welcome back to my channel, A Little Bit of Everything, where I talk about a little bit of everything. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at Fifth Harmony's career, how the group was formed, how they became one of the most successful girl groups, and how the overworking that they suffered at the hands of their label and management ultimately led to their downfall. I hope you guys enjoy the video, make sure to like and subscribe, and let's get into it. Fifth Harmony was created by Sam and Cowell during the second season of The X Factor USA. The group consisted of Ali Brooke from San Antonio, Texas, who blew away the judges with her performance of On My Knees by Jesse Velasquez, Normani Corday, who was originally from Atlanta, Georgia, but was raised in Louisiana and later moved to Texas in 2005 due to Hurricane Katrina. She auditioned with a performance of the song Chain of Fools by Aretha Franklin and received compliments from Demi Lovato, who told her that she had the X Factor. Dinah Jane from Santa Ana, California, who impressed the judges with her amazing vocals at such a young age, with her interpretation of If I Were a Boy by Beyonce. Lauren Jauregui from Miami, Florida, who amazed the judges with her husky voice with a rendition of If I Ain't Got You by Alicia Keys. And Camila Cabello from Havana, Cuba, whose audition was never televised because she performed Respect by Aretha Franklin and the show didn't have the rights to that song. So we don't really know what the judges told her, but they were definitely impressed. Despite the judges being very happy with their solo performance, both during the audition and during the boot camp, all of the girls were eliminated as the judges didn't think that they had what it took. However, they were all asked to go back on stage, where Simon Cowell told them that they were welcome to continue their journey on the show as a group. All of the girls excitedly agreed and moved on to the next round to perform at Simon's house in front of him and Mark Anthony. The girls performed Impossible by Chantel as their first performance together. The girls were very nervous, but they completely nailed it. Each of them got to show their amazing vocals by singing a part of the song solo, and then at the end they showed how well they worked as a group by finishing the song in a beautiful harmony. With this performance, the group was able to earn their position on the next stage of the program, the live shows. During the live stage part, the group actually struggled quite a bit and were the underdog for the entirety of the competition. During week one, they performed a rendition of We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together by Taylor Swift. If I'm honest, this is my least favorite performance from the group on the show. The girls sounded great, but the arrangement wasn't really good, and all of the girls seemed uneasy and nervous on stage, with the exception of Camila. And I'm not the only person who thought that, since this is the ever-so-famous performance, where Demi Lovato says that Camila is the only member of the group who stands out. By the end of the episode, the group had been chosen by Simon to be on the bottom two and had to seek for their lives. During the elimination round, the group performed a beautiful and emotional rendition of Skyscraper by Demi Lovato, which earned them a spot on the next round. For the following weeks, the group would go up and down on the ranking, but always remained in the top 10. They gave some really solid and amazing performances, which are some of my favorite performances from their entire career. Some of their best performances on the show are their performances of A Thousand Years by Christina Perri, Hero by Mariah Carey, Set Fire to the Rain by Adele, their Spanglish performance of Impossible, and Let It Be by the Beatles. On week 6, during the quarterfinals, the group had to perform two songs, and despite both being great, the girls were at the bottom and had to sing in order to move on to the next round. During their survival round, they performed Anytime You Need a Friend by Mariah Carey and earned a spot in the semifinals. During the semifinals, the group got to perform two songs once again. The first performance was a rendition of Anything Could Happen by Ellie Goulding, and the second one was the Spanglish version of Impossible by Chantel. The group ranked second and moved on to the finals. During the finale, the group performed four songs. The first one was Anything Could Happen by Ellie Goulding. The second one was Give Your Heart a Break, which they performed alongside Demi. The third song was Let It Be by the Beatles. And lastly, they performed Christmas Baby Please Come Home by Darlene Love. The group finished third and were eliminated. However, this wouldn't be the end of Fifth Harmony, and the group would get a third chance to make their dreams come true. On January 17th, 2013, it was announced that Fifth Harmony would be signing a recording contract with Syco Music and Epic Records. Throughout the rest of 2013, the group would upload multiple covers onto their YouTube channel in which they showed their growth and cohesion as a group. Some of my favorite performances from this time were their covers of Red by Taylor Swift, Lego House by Ed Sheeran, Stay by Rihanna, Honeymoon Avenue by Ariana Grande, and Thinking About You by Frank Ocean. So, as you can see, the group didn't have an easy time gaining success and momentum. They straight out the gate were being criticized by the judges for not seeming like a cohesive unit. This was actually the main criticism that they got every week by A. Leigh Reid. And while I disagree with this statement, I think things would just get worse from then on. I was one of the people who saw and supported the girls every week while the show was airing, and I loved them. I was obsessed with them. I was constantly watching and listening to their performances as if they were real songs. Well, it's now become a meme that Fifth Harmony didn't like each other, that they were mismatched, and that they were five soloists first in a group, which it's kind of accurate to a certain degree. I think that this pre-debut era was their peak as a group. They never looked or sounded better as a unit than in this moment, in my opinion. Nowadays, some people refer to the group as Camila and the rest, but during the show, especially during the first 3 or 4 weeks, that really wasn't the case. Normani, Dinah, and especially Lauren were the ones that mostly sang lead, and Ali and Camila were used as reinforcement for the group vocals since they had the most different sounding voices in the group. Around week 3 or 4, Camila started to take more stage center in the group, but it was still well balanced by Lauren because she was still mostly the lead vocal during the performances, and the other girls still had a lot of time and lines. So even though Camila was getting more prominent parts, everyone still had time to shine. Like I said, this was, in my opinion, the group in their peak. They looked happy, they looked comfortable on stage, they were very confident. During performances, they would interact with each other a lot, making everything look cohesive. Their outfits, while very different and suited to their individual style, always had a theme that made them all look like a group, like a unit. And I personally think that this time was the vocal peak of most of the members. On June 15th, 2013, the audio of the group's first single, Miss Moving On, was uploaded onto their YouTube channel. 2 days later, on June 18th, a lyrics video came out in which the girls can be seen holding signs with the song's lyrics, and almost a month later, on July 15th, the official music video was released. The song debuted at number 87 on the Hot 100 after selling 37,000 copies and eventually peaked at number 72, and it was certified gold in the US after selling 500,000 copies. The same day the music video was released, the group embarked on their first tour, the Harmonized American Mole Tour, where the girls performed 22 shows from July 15th to August 16th, 2013. During this tour, the girls performed all of the songs from their upcoming EP, as well as covers of Taylor Swift's Red and I Knew You Were Trouble, Rihanna's Stay, and Katy Perry's Teenage Dream. On July 18th, the group released Me and My Girls as a promotional single. The song peaked at number 4 on the Bubbling Under chart, and the music video was released on August 24th on the Disney Channel. A different version was also uploaded onto the group's YouTube channel the next day. The girls promoted these songs with performances on the Today Show on July 18th and on week 3 of season 3 of The X Factor, as well as performances during the rest of the year on Fox and Friends, The Arsenio Hall Show, and Live with Kelly and Michael. In September, the group became the opening act for Cher Lloyd's I Wish Tour. The tour went on from September 6th to October 12th, 2013. On October 22nd, the group released their long-awaited EP, Better Together. The standard version of the EP had 5 songs: Don't Wanna Dance Alone, Miss Moving On, Better Together, Who Are You, and Leave My Heart Out of This. The iTunes version had 1 added track, Me and My Girls, and the Target version of the album came with 1 extra song, One Wish. The EP debuted at number 6 on the Hot 200 after selling 28,000 copies in its first week. On October 25th, the girls started their second tour, Fifth Harmony 2013 Tour, which had 6 shows, 4 in the USA and 2 in Canada. It went on from October 25th to November 5th, 2013, and the track list consisted of all of the songs from the EP and covers of Red by Taylor Swift, Avenue Honeymoon by Ariana Grande, Stay by Rihanna, and Anything Could Happen by Ellie Goulding. On November 8th, 2013, the group released a Spanish version of their EP called Juntos, which had Spanish versions of all of the songs. It debuted at number 2 on the Top Latin Album and peaked at number 1. That same day, the acoustic version of Juntos was released. It debuted and peaked at number 2 on the top Latin albums. The Better Together acoustic EP came out on November 15th, 2013 and peaked at number 189 on the Hot 200. Lastly, the Better Together remixes EP came out on November 25th, 2013 and was only released digitally. The girls closed their very hectic year off with an acoustic performance for Billboard, a performance on the red carpet of the AMAs, and performances at different Jingle Bell balls across the country, including Florida, Atlanta, and LA. Starting out 2014, the girls will go on tour once again as an opening act for Demi Lovato on her The Neon Lights tour. The girls performed from February 9th until May 30th. Their set list consisted of the 5 songs of the standard version of Better Together and a cover of Miss Independent by Destiny's Child. With this tour, on top of performing in the US and Canada, the girls also performed in Brazil, Colombia, Argentina, Chile, Ecuador, and Mexico. Simultaneously, the girls held their own solo tour called the Worst Kept Secret Tour from February 2nd until March 24th. The girls performed 5 sold-out shows in front of a total of 8,890 people. From May 3rd to July 18th, the girls held a summer tour called 5th Times a Charm Tour. There were 18 shows, one in Puerto Rico, one in Canada, and the rest in the US. And with this, the Better Together era was officially over. On July 4th, 2014, the group released a snippet of their next single on their social media. The song, Boss, and its music video were released online on MTV's website on July 7th and were uploaded on Fifth Harmony's official YouTube channel on July 8th. The song debuted at number 43 on the Hot 100 with first week sales of 75,000. Becoming the group's best week sales as well as highest charting song at the time. The song charted for 15 weeks. It was certified platinum after selling 1 million copies in the US and silver in the UK after selling 200,000 copies. On July 25th, the group served as the opening act for Austin Mahone's tour. From July 25th until September 10th, and then again from October 10th until October 12th. On October 23rd, the group teased their follow-up single, Sledgehammer. The music video was posted on their YouTube channel on October 25th, and the song was officially released on October 28th. The song debuted at number 93 on the Hot 100, eventually rising and peaking at number 40. The song was certified platinum in the US after selling 1 million copies, and gold in Canada after selling 40,000 copies. For the promotions of the songs, they perform at the red carpet of the BMAs, the AMA's kickoff party, they also performed on The X Factor, on MTV's Artist to Watch Live, on the AMA's Red Carpet Radio, on Good America, they also performed an acoustic version on Access Hollywood Live, they performed on a live studio session for a Billboard, they performed on VH1's Big Morning Buzz Live, and closed the year by performing on Pitbull's New Year's Revolution Party that aired on Fox. The girls started 2015 with a bang. On January 30th, they released their first full album, Reflection. The standard version of the album had 11 songs, which are Top Down, Boss, Sledgehammer, Worth It, This Is How We Roll, Everlasting Love, Like Mariah, Them Girls Be Like, Reflection, Sugar Mama, and We Know. The deluxe version had 3 extra songs, which were Going Nowhere, Body Rock, and Brave, Honest, Beautiful. The Google Play bonus track included I'm in Love with a Monster and a Spanish version of Worth It, and the Japan Deluxe version included songs from Better Together. The album debuted at number 5 on the Hot 100 with 80,000 equivalent album units, with 62,000 of those coming from pure album sales. It also charted in 19 other countries, including Brazil, the UK, France, and Mexico. It was certified gold and platinum in 3 countries, including the US, after selling 1 million copies. For the early promotion of the album, the girls performed Sledgehammer on The Talk, The Today Show, on Sunrise, and on The Ellen Show in the beginning of 2015. On February 25th, the group started their first world tour, the Reflection Tour, which would see them perform in 87 shows in 3 continents from February 25th, 2015 until February 12th, 2016. The girls performed in the US, Canada, Mexico, Bahamas, Spain, Netherlands, Germany, France, UK, and United Arab Emirates. On March 2nd, the group released the 3rd and last single for Reflection, Worth It, featuring Kid Ink. A few days later, on March 28th, the music video was released at the People's Choice Awards. The song debuted at number 82 on the Hot 100, exited the charts, and re-entered it in the 3rd week at number 93. It would exit once again, this time for 4 weeks, before charting at number 92. The promotion from the video gave the song a 20-spot jump at number 58. It eventually peaked at number 12 on August 18th. The song gained many certifications. It was certified 2x platinum in Australia, Canada, and Italy, gold in Austria, Belgium, Denmark, Germany, New Zealand, and Spain, and it was certified 4x platinum in the US after selling 4 million copies. The performance schedule for the promotion of Worth It was much more hectic than the promotion for the previous singles. The song was performed for the first time on VH1's Big Morning Bus Live. It was also performed on Live with Kelly and Michael, on the Radio Disney Music Awards, on the finale of Dancing with the Stars, on Good Morning Britain, on CBBC's Friday Download. They performed the song with Kid Ink for the first time on Jimmy Kimmel's live show, making their late night show debut as well. But that's not all. They performed on the Today Show, at the 2015 Premios Juventud, and the season finale of the Latin American singing competition La Banda, where they sang a mix of the Spanish and English version of the song. They performed at the BET Players Awards and at the red carpet of the EMAs. On August 15, I'm in Love with a Monster was released as a promotional single for the movie Hotel Transylvania 2 alongside a music video. The girls performed the song on the Late Late James Corden show and on the Ryan Seacrest radio show. On November 18th, 2015, Camila became the first member to take part in a project outside of the group after she was featured on Shawn Mendes' song I Know What You Did Last Summer. The song debuted at number 97 on the Billboard Hot 100 and peaked at number 20. This era marked the beginning of the end of the group, not only because Camila was taking more and more center stage while the rest of the members were being kind of forgotten, but also because, and especially towards the end of the year, the girls seemed visibly tired. And who can blame them? Look at that schedule. I would be surprised if there was a single week in the entire year where the girls didn't perform at least once. The girls also lost family members during this time. Lauren lost her grandmother the same day the reflection was released, and Dinah said that she had to see her grandmother's burial over FaceTime. Another thing that I don't think people really talk about that much nowadays is the sexualization of the girls. All of the members, minus Ali, were underage when Worth It was released. The song had very sexually suggestive lyrics, they wore very revealing outfits on stage, and all of their choreos involved twerking to some degree. Camila spoke about this in an interview in 2017 when she said, "Especially with being in a girl group, there's been a lot of times where people have tried to sexualize us just to get more attention. Unfortunately, sex sells. There's definitely been times when there's stuff that I have not been comfortable with and I've put my foot down." Thankfully, towards the end of 2015, the girls teamed up with the lawyer Dina LaPole and managed to get better contracts. Dina said that the group had one of the worst contracts that she had ever seen in the industry and transferred the group's name copyright from Simon and on to the girls. However, this didn't mean that the overworking was over and the girls would continue to be worked into the ground the following year. On February 26, 2016, the group released the first single of their follow-up album, Work From Home, featuring Ty Dolla $ign. This song is by far their most successful and famous. The song debuted at number 12 on the Billboard Hot 100 with 80,000 downloads, equaling the peak position of Worth It. The song eventually peaked at number 4, becoming the group's first top 5 hit. The song got many certifications around the world, including 3x platinum in the UK after selling 1.8 million units, and 5x platinum in the US after selling 5 million units. You know how people nowadays like to make fun of Fifth Harmony's performances? Well, they're mostly talking about the performances of the promotional period of Work From Home. Their first performance was a special after Oscars episode of Live with Kelly and Michael, where only Camila and Armani sounded good. Lauren has one line in the song that she mostly lip syncs in performances when they have to dance, and Dinah and Ali sounded completely out of breath. They then gave the ever so famous Jimmy Kimmel performance where Ali hammers a tire and Lauren drills it. They also performed at the VMAs, and this is the performance where Camila awkwardly twerks on Ty Dolla $ign. They also gave other performances that were actually really good, like their performance on The Ellen Show, on Britain's Got Talent, and the Much Music Video Awards. On March 24th, The Life was released as the first promotional single of the album. The song peaked at number one on the Bubbling Under chart. Right on Me was then released as the second promotional single on May 5th, and it peaked at number 173 and remained on the chart for 1 week. On May 27, 2016, the group released their second full studio album, 727. This name is a reference to the date in which the group was formed. The standard version of the album has 10 songs on it, those being That's My Girl, Work From Home, The Life, Ride On Me, I Lied, All In My Head, Squeeze, Gonna Get Better, Scared To Be Happy, and Not That Kind of Girl. The deluxe version includes two extra songs called Dope and No Way. The UK standard and deluxe version include a version of Worth It without the rap verse, and the Japanese version includes two extra songs called Big Bad Wolf and 1000 Hands. 727 debuted and peaked at number 4 on the Hot 200, earning 74,000 equivalent album units, 49,000 of those being traditional album sales in its first week, and becoming the group's highest charting album to date. The album was certified in multiple countries, including platinum in the US, after selling 1 million units. On May 31st, the group released All In My Head, featuring Fetty Wap. The song debuted at number 78 on the US Billboard Hot 100 and peaked at number 24. It was certified in multiple countries, including platinum in the US, after selling 1 million units. The group performed the song for the first time on May 22nd during a special encore performance on Xfinity following the 2016 Billboard Music Awards. The group performed the song on the 22nd season finale of Dancing with the Stars. They also performed it on the iHeartRadio Honda stage, at the grand finale of the 5th season of The Voice Australia, and on Sunrise. On June 22nd, the group started their second world tour, which would see them perform in 67 shows in 4 continents, from June 22nd, 2016 to September 15th, 2017. The group performed on Brazil, Peru, Chile, Argentina, USA, Canada, Ireland, UK, Spain, Portugal, France, Germany, Denmark, Sweden, Norway, Luxembourg, Netherlands, Belgium, Guatemala, Japan, China, Hong Kong, Taiwan, Philippines, Malaysia, and Singapore. 9 of the concerts from September 13th to November 3rd were cancelled without explanation, and only 4 of them were reprogrammed. On September 27th, the group released the third and last single of 727, as well as their last single as 5, That's My Girl. The song debuted on the Billboard Hot 100 at number 73. The song rose to its peak position of 19 after charting for 6 weeks, earning the group their 4th top 20 single on this chart. The song was certified gold in 5 countries, including the US, after selling 500,000 copies. The group performed the song for the first time on television at the American Music Awards. An alternative music video was released on September 28, 2016, and features scenes from the web series DC Superhero Girls and the movie DC Superhero Girls Hero of the Year. On August, the group went through their first big controversy. After an interview with Normani in which she was asked to describe the group members was published. When she got to Camila, she described her as quirky and cute. This description angered and enraged Camila fans, who started to send racial attacks to Normani, leading to her making the decision to leave Twitter. On August 7, she posted a lengthy statement on Twitter in which she said, "Over the course of this last week, and especially over the last 48 hours, I've not just been cyberbullied, I've been racially cyberbullied, with tweets and pictures so horrific and racially charged that I can't subject myself any longer to the hate." Following this, all of the members defended her. Lauren also posted a long note in which she said, "Normani is like a sister to me, and when I see her mother crying because of things people were saying about her daughter, and I found out what exactly it was that was disturbing her, I was appalled. Racism is something that none of us tolerates." Ali posted a note in which she said, "I am very sad to see my sister and her family hurt, to live in a world where so much darkness can occur. For racial slurs to even be a thing, to have seen what I saw, is incredibly devastating." Dinah tweeted, "Over the past 48 hours, I've heard and seen too much over an issue that is so small, but yet has become so big. With all the pain in the world right now, it shocks me each and every day that people still devote their time to bringing others down other than lift them up. It does not make you cool, it does not make you clever, it makes you a damn coward, nothing else." Lastly, Camila made a series of tweets in which she said, "I stand by the words love only, meaning I won't tolerate on my timeline any kind of abuse, racism, or discrimination towards anyone, period. I don't think that at the time they garnered much attention, but I remember this being the first time where I saw Camila's racist Tumblr post, but we will talk about those in a bit. On October 14th, Camila was featured on Machine Gun Kelly's Bad Things. The song debuted at number 80 on the US Billboard Hot 100 and peaked at number 4 in its 13th week on the chart, and spent 23 weeks in total in it. It was certified in multiple countries, including 5 times platinum in the US after selling 5 million units. On December 9th, Lauren took part in her first project outside of the group when she was featured on the Marian Hill song Back to Me. On December 12th, the group performed at the iHeartRadio Jingle Bell Festival. This would become the group's last performance as Five, as only 6 days later, on December 18th, the group would announce through a statement that Camila would be leaving the group. They said, "After 4.5 years of being together, we have been informed by her representatives that Camila has decided to leave Fifth Harmony. That being said, we are excited to announce that we will be moving forward with the four of us, Ali Brooks, Normani Corday, Dinah Jane, and Lauren Jauregui, for our fans. We are four strong, committed women who will continue with Fifth Harmony, as well as our solo endeavors. We are excited for our future, and we can't wait for what the new year brings. Harmonizers, we are in this together. We love you with all of our hearts. Love, Ali, Normani, Dinah, and Lauren." The next day, Camila released her own statement in which she said, "I was shocked to read the statement that Fifth Harmony's account posted without my knowing. The girls were aware of my feelings throughout the long, much-needed conversations about the future we had during the tour. Saying that they were just informed through my representatives that I was leaving the group is simply not true." The next day, on the 20th, Fifth Harmony put out a second statement in which they said, "Over the past several months, we have consistently made every effort to sit down and discuss the future of Fifth Harmony with Camila. We have spent the past year and a half since her initial solo endeavor trying to communicate to her and her team all of the reasons why we felt Fifth Harmony deserved at least one more album of her time, given the success of the past year that we've all worked so hard for. We called for group meetings, which she refused. We asked LA Reid and the label to step in and try to set meetings, which again, she refused. We even went as far as group counseling, which she did not show up to. After months of rejection from her and her team, the supposed lengthy conversations, in fact, never happened. Although we pleaded. We have tried with exhausted efforts and hearts to keep this group alive as the five of us, and we wanted to be very clear that unfortunately, those efforts were not mutual." But the year wouldn't end without one more drama. And that same day, a clip of Lauren talking with Ali leaked in which she said,
"Making decisions on a regular basis to fuck us over, to make us literal slaves. Like, literally slaves, Ali. We're doing labor every day and we see nothing."
And with all this drama, Fifth Harmony finishes their very successful 2016. Starting out the new year, on January 6, 2017, the group released their first photo as Four, and on January 18th, they performed for the first time as Four at the People's Choice Awards. Camila, on the other hand, had her first performance since leaving the group on The Ellen Show with Machine Gun Kelly on January 30th. On February 17th, Camila had her first interview since leaving the group, in which she said, "Fifth Harmony was in the maximum expression of me individually. My fans are really going to know me from the music I'm writing. My goal is to be brave and open up my soul." On April 12th, the group gave their first interview since Camila leaving, where they said, "The four of us are really in sync with each other. We're pretty open about most things. We try to respect each other as much as we can. For us, communication is really important." On May 26th, Lauren was featured on the song Strangers from Halsey's album Hopeless Fountain Kingdom. The song peaked at number 100 on the Hot 100 and was certified gold in Brazil after selling 20,000 copies. On June 2nd, the group released the first single of their upcoming album, Down, featuring Gucci Mane. The song debuted and peaked at number 42 on the Hot 100. It ran from June 24th to September 16th, remaining a total of 10 non-consecutive weeks on the chart, and it was certified gold in 3 countries, including the US, after selling 500,000 units. The first live performance of the song was on Good Morning America. They also promoted the single on the iHeartRadio Summer Pool Party, on The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, at the BMAs, on Rock Crops event, and at the Tidal X benefit concert. On June 9th, Ali had her first project outside of the group when she was featured on American DJ duo Lost Kingdom's song Look at Us Now, alongside American rapper A$AP Ferg. On August 25th, the group released their third and last album, Fifth Harmony. The standard version of the album had 10 songs, which were Down, He Like That, Sauced Up, Make You Mad, Deliver, Lonely Night, Don't Say You Love Me, Angel, Messy, and Bridges. The Spotify version had one bonus track, Por Favor, and the Japanese version had an instrumental version of Down. The album debuted at number 4 on the Hot 200 with 46,000 equivalent units. It reached the same peak as 727, making it Fifth Harmony's 4th consecutive top 10 and 3rd top 5 album, equaling the number of top 10 albums from all female acts, Destiny's Child and Dixie Chicks. On August 10th, Angel was released as a promotional single. The song peaked at number 12 on the Bubbling Under chart. On September 8th, the group released Deliver as the second promotional single, and it didn't chart. On September 19th, the group released their second single, He Like That. The single became their first one not to enter the Billboard Hot 100, peaking at number 1 on the Bubbling Under chart. The girls performed the song on Good Morning America, The Late Late Night Show with James Corden, and on Live with Kelly and Michael. On September 29th, the group went on their third world tour, which would see them performing 28 shows in 3 continents, from September 29th, 2017 until May 11th, 2018. The group performed in Argentina, Chile, Brazil, Mexico, Panama, Costa Rica, Canada, USA, Japan, Thailand, Philippines, Indonesia, Singapore, and United Arab Emirates. Night shows, which were supposed to take place in Puerto Rico, Australia, New Zealand, and the US, were canceled. These were the dates from October 24th until May 16th. On August 28th, the group performed at the VMAs. They performed Down and Angel, and in the beginning of the performance, there were the 4 girls and a mannequin that was later thrown off the stage. The girls later explained their intentions with this by saying, "Well, we get asked all the time if we're getting a fifth member, and we wanted to show the world in an artistic way that, hey, the 4 of us are Fifth Harmony, and we're stronger and better than we've ever been. And honestly, it was such a monumental moment for us." When asked about it, Camila said, "It definitely hurt my feelings. I wasn't expecting it. I wasn't prepared for it, especially because at that point, I'd moved on from it. I was just like, what? Why?" On October 27th, the group released their last single, Por Favor, alongside Pitbull. The song peaked at number 15 on the Hot Latin Song chart. They performed the song at the finale of the 25th season of Dancing with the Stars and at the Latin American Music Awards. That same day, Lauren was featured on the song In Your Phone by Ty Dolla $ign from his album Beach House 3, and Dinah collabed with Red One, Daddy Yankee, and French Montana on the song Boom Boom. On November 17th, Lauren released the song All Night with Steve Aoki. The song was featured on his album Neon Future 3 and peaked at number 9 on the Hot Dance Electronic Songs chart. On January 26, 2018, Ali collaborated with German DJ Topic for the song Perfect. On February 14th, Normani released her debut single Love Lies with Khalid from the Love, Simon soundtrack, making her the last of the group to release a solo single. The song reached over 50 million Spotify streams in less than a month and debuted at number 43 on the Billboard Hot 100, eventually peaking at number 9. On March 16th, 2018, the group announced that they would be going on an indefinite hiatus to pursue solo endeavors. They said, "Reflecting on the past 6 years since we started on The X Factor, we've realized just how far we've come and we appreciate everything so much more now than ever. After 6 years going hard non-stop, we also realized that in order to stay authentic to ourselves and to you, we do need to take some time for now to go on a hiatus from Fifth Harmony in order to pursue solo endeavors." On May 18th, 2018, the group released Don't Say You Love Me as the album's 3rd and final promotional single. And with this, Fifth Harmony comes to an end. Fifth Harmony has, without a doubt, cemented their position as one of the biggest and most successful girl groups in history. But I think that the plan was never for them to have a long-lasting career. I think that from the beginning, Psycho and Epic wanted to milk the group for as much money as they could before turning their focus on who for them was the real star, Camila. It seems that all of the girls are much happier being solo artists and are putting out the type of music that they truly want to make. As someone who followed the group from its creation on The X Factor, seeing them fall was definitely sad and it felt like the end of an era, but I think that they're all much better now for it. That was all for today's video. Let me know what you think of all this. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!